So hi, hello and welcome again. Oliver here, Microbehunter here, and today in this video I would like to explain why we have to put food into the refrigerator or into the freezer to keep it fresh. And the answer has to do something with the growth of microorganisms such as bacteria and as fungi. Why is temperature so important? Well, because at a low temperature, bacteria and fungi are not able to divide as quickly. They're not able to reproduce as quickly. And why is it important to reduce the reproduction rate of those microbes? Well, because when they grow, when they divide, and when they multiply, they will use the food, our food that we eat or that we want to eat, they will use that food as an energy source, as a food source. And by reducing the temperature, the metabolism of the bacteria and fungi, these are all of the chemical reactions that happen inside the cells, the metabolism is also reduced. At a lower temperature, chemical reactions happen much slower. And for this reason, bacteria and fungi are also not able to divide them as quickly. Now, how do they actually feed off the food? Well, they release enzymes, digestive enzymes, which break down the food. And then the nutrients that are formed this way are being absorbed back into the cells, into the bacteria and fungi, and they use this as an energy source and also to grow and to reproduce. And by lowering the temperature, well, we're slowing down the process. However, at a very low temperature, well, actually when water is frozen and even colder, at minus 20, 22 degrees, this is extremely cold, life almost comes to a complete standstill. The water molecules are not able to move freely anymore. Everything is locked in into ice, and this causes the metabolism, the chemical reactions to come almost to a complete standstill. Because it's important in a cell to have liquid water. And when the water is moving, then all of the chemicals can move around as well. And then chemical reactions can happen at frozen temperature when everything's locked in place into an ice crystal. Everything comes to a standstill. For this reason, it's basically possible to keep food fresh in the freezer almost indefinitely. And as a matter of fact, scientists have found some frozen animals in the permafrost. Permafrost is the region of the world where the ground never thaws up. It's always frozen throughout the year. And if animals they've found animals there that have been preserved for thousands of years even. So you see, at that temperature, life really comes to a standstill. But I would like to talk a little bit about the other extreme as well. What about high temperatures? Let's say when we start boiling the food. And you've also heard that when you boil water, for example, then you can make it safer to drink. Why is that? Well, because at boiling of the temperature, the enzymes, these are proteins inside the cells that control the chemical reactions, the enzymes inside the cells, they break. There's a term called denaturing. They change their shape in such a way that they're not able to do the chemical reactions anymore. And this is irreversible. You see, at cold temperatures, the cells, the bacteria and fungi still might be able to survive. And when you thaw up the food, they become active again. Then they start reproducing again. That's why you're not supposed to freeze and thaw it repeatedly, because then you don't know how long it has the bacteria have reproduced. But at high temperature, once you go over this critical value, the enzymes, they start to break and the cell dies off. And this is not reversible. And we've seen this as well. For example, when we freeze meat or egg, you cannot, then you thaw it up again, it's still raw, right? But when you boil meat or egg, well, that's not reversible. The shape and texture of the food has changed completely. Same thing happens inside the microorganisms. You boil them, then basically, they die, because the proteins that control the chemical reactions, they don't work anymore, and that is irreversible. So I hope I explained now not only why we put food into the freezer and into the refrigerator, but also why boiling food is important to kill possibly harmful bacteria and fungi. I wish you all the best. Bye-bye.